Welcome to today's masterclass about branding your YouTube channel. Now, you might already have a YouTube channel, you might want to start a YouTube channel, not have one yet. Wherever you are, branding your YouTube channel is something essential and not very hard to do. So I'm gonna give you the five elements that you need to brand your YouTube channel. And that basically means making it reflect who you are and the story you wanna tell. And that's actually step one, is to figure out, before you brand your YouTube channel, is just figure out what story do you wanna tell with it. Who are you as a YouTube creator? What do you wanna help people with? What's the impact that you wanna make with your YouTube channel? What kind of videos are you gonna create? Really like think about and start to vision what are the possibilities for your YouTube channel? Is it going to be a bunch of talking head videos, kind of like this one? Or is it going to be a mix of different types of videos? Are you gonna have a web series on there and then some informational content? What do you want your YouTube channel to look like and how is it gonna help people? Once you get really clear on what that story is you're gonna tell, then you'll have a much easier time branding your YouTube channel. So here are the five elements for branding your YouTube channel. The first one that you need is a channel name. Now, if you are an individual creator and all of these videos are going to be featuring you, created by you, created, you know, you're the center of it, you want it to be your name. Even if you have a brand and you have like a separate name for your brand, so many YouTube creators that I've seen who've started as brands go back to their original name. So, and that is only because a lot of times you'll start with something in mind. So let's say you're like, I wanna be the queen of gluten-free cooking on a YouTube channel, right? You might title your YouTube channel Gluten-Free Chef Mindy. Just threw that name out there. Gluten-free chef Mindy. Then what happens if you want to pivot and you want to start doing like other kinds of cooking, or if you want to do making vegan meals or something like that, right? So it doesn't really leave a lot of room for you to pivot if you put yourself into that box to start with. So to create, when you first create a YouTube channel, highly recommend to make it your name. And then you can create anything under it that you want and you can pivot as you wish, all right? Number two, you need a channel icon, which is basically just a headshot. The channel icon is that little circle that appears next to your YouTube channel. So if people will search for the name of your YouTube channel, your little circle icon will pop up. You want it to be a clear photo, a headshot, something that really shows off your personality. And then you want it to be professional. So if you have like a selfie photo, that'll do for now, but try to get something a little bit more professional to use as your channel icon, because this photo also shows up, it's really cool, in the comments section. So if you comment on any other videos, which I highly recommend you do, we can talk about that in another masterclass, but if you comment on someone else's video, it will pop up with the name of your channel as well as your channel icon. And a lot of times these channel icons are the default ones. So it'll be a little circle with like a P in it or a K in it. And I'm sure you've seen those, right? The ones that are branded have that nice channel icon that's just like so clickable. And it's like, oh my God, she looks like fun. Whatever she's creating, I'm on board. I'm gonna click on her channel and subscribe, right? So create a channel icon, literally just a headshot, done. The next thing is channel art. Channel art is a little bit trickier. I like to create channel art on Canva. However, the dimensions that Canva gives you is not necessarily the dimensions that YouTube will show. So you're gonna have to like, I have some workarounds for this in my YouTube course, but if you wanna create channel art by yourself, just look up I would Google YouTube channel art template and it'll give you the dimensions within the Canva dimensions. So it'll be the 1080, 1920 by 1080 kind of situation, like this frame, right? And then right here in the middle, this tiny little strip in the middle is the only part that will show on YouTube. So you can download a template that will show you exactly what part of that shows on YouTube. So get some channel art, make it nice and branded. It can literally just be a photo of you and your name and your channel name. You can include a tagline in there, which I highly recommend because that will tell people what your channel's all about, especially if your channel title is your name. That doesn't give people much information. So telling people what your channel is about in the tagline and the channel art is highly recommended, gives people more information, right? Make it fun. Let it, you know, let it reflect the story you want to tell on your channel. So that's number three. Number four is your about description. This is really important and often overlooked, but it is really great for SEO. So you can plug your keywords into your about description on your YouTube channel, and then you'll get a lot more search results when people are searching for that specific thing. So if you are talking about gluten-free cooking or baking, you can put that keyword in several times in your about description, and that'll just boost your SEO, all right? And then the last one is the links. So on your channel art, in the bottom right corner of the channel art, you can add links there, and those go to external links, your website, your Instagram, any social media you have, a program that you want to sell, a product that you have, right? It can go to any external source. It can lead to your opt-in and send people through an email funnel, right? So put some links on there and make sure that you have a solid strategy behind it. So why, ask yourself when you're incorporating these links into your YouTube channel, why are you doing it? Is it to generate leads? Is it to get people to buy your product? Is it to get more followers on Instagram? Are you trying to funnel people there? So understand sort of the purpose and the strategy behind putting these links on there. And that'll just allow you to capture this traffic that you're gonna get from YouTube, capture that traffic and move it to whichever place you desire in your sales funnel, all right? So let me recap. We've got, for branding your YouTube channel, first and foremost, decide what story you want to tell, what you want it to look like. That can always change, it can always pivot as you get more information about what your audience desires from you. But start with what you want to create, like what is fun for you to create, okay? And when you're branding your channel, have a channel name that encompasses everything that you could possibly ever create. Create a channel icon, which is a headshot, channel art, channel about, the about description for your channel, and then add some links in there so that you can move people into your nice, beautiful sales funnels and everything. All right, that is the masterclass on branding your YouTube channel.